Thank you, Johnny. Jim David from Land Bank, Assistant Vice President. Land Bank is the largest government bank, which ranks only to BDO Unibank among the top banks in the country. Jim, how will LBP support our redevelopment?
Thank you, Sir Pete. Good afternoon to all, and thank you to Terrapinn for having Land Bank here as among the panelists. And to our viewers, welcome to the Future Energy Show 2021. I am Jim David, a civil engineer by profession and a banker by heart. And the bank will always be here to close any financing gap to push through with your energy projects. Land Bank is a universal bank that is 100% owned by the Philippine government. And we are the second largest bank in the country with a total asset of more than 2.4 trillion pesos. Land Bank is located in all provinces of the country and in almost all municipalities and cities. We have more than 411 full banking branches all over the country, 66 branch light units, 55 lending centers, and 2,216 ATMs. Land Bank is a financially robust bank and will continuously pursue its mandate to serve the countryside and extend its reach more to the unbanked sectors of the country and to the real energy development projects. Because in this time and age, it is very unfortunate to see some areas in the Philippines that are still unenergized. This is despite the vast energy resources the country has, and despite the fact that energy development technology is more accessible and relatively more affordable today compared to decades ago. There are indeed gaps to close in order to fully energize our country. Nonetheless, at Land Bank, together with its partner energy developers, had been so far successful in closing the financial gap for the development of renewable energy projects and the adoption of energy efficient solutions. Land Bank finances sustainable energy resources development projects and projects that will cut down the use of energy by adopting energy efficient solutions for industries, offices, and even down to big energy users like the big residential owners. Way back in 2012, I believe, the bank had rolled out a lending program that finances renewable energy project. And in 2018, we launched the Go Green lending program that is for the high energy users can top to finance their energy conservation projects by adopting available energy efficient solutions like thermal insulation for buildings that will cut down air conditioning costs by as much as 40%, using of energy efficient appliances and equipment like the high energy efficient motors for industries, solar rooftop, even rainwater collection system, automated lighting and equipment systems, and the simple use of LED lightings for factories, among others. This is in order to cut down not only the electricity cost, but as well as the carbon footprints that we leave in doing our daily lives. As Senator Gatchalan said this morning, a kilowatt save is a kilowatt save in producing energy. And to show you how far have the bank gone in financing energy projects and how the bank continuously contributes in mitigating further climate change using its bank's financial muscles, the bank financed multi-billion renewable energy and energy efficient projects. In fact, we financed more than 24 biogas projects, 2 cogeneration projects, 1 geothermal project, 10 hydropower projects, 19 solar projects, and 1 wind power project. And currently, we're working on financing an ocean energy project, which will be the first power project in the country that will harness the ocean waves to produce sustainable power. In total, the bank has financed more than 742 megawatts of renewable energy projects. If we look at this production capacity in terms of reduction of our carbon dioxide emission, we are talking here of around 2.8 billion kilograms of carbon dioxide reduction in a year, which could have further degraded our atmosphere and contribute a lot to climate change, which destroys lives and economies, as we have witnessed in a very recent events that happened in the USA, Europe, and even in China. Therefore, may I encourage our friends in the energy sector to look into the vast energy resources that the Philippines is generously gifted by nature. We have a vast shorelines and bays that are potential for wind, tidal, or ocean energy. Our country has longer irrigation hours compared to European countries that we can maximize the development of solar power projects. The irony is we still rely heavily on fossil fuel to power our plants. Let us stop coal, let us stop diesel power plant. We have to fast track, especially now that the demand for energy has tapered. While in COVID pandemic, in preparation for a more vibrant economy under a new normal, and in the advent of electric cars, electric railway systems coming to our country 2 to 5 years from now, that will jack up the need for a more stable and reliable energy system for the country. And for any financial need for your viable renewable energy projects or even energy efficient projects, please rest assured that Land Bank is your bank in ensuring that your goals become realities. You can view our site at www.landbank.com for details on how to avail the universal bank services that Land Bank can offer to you. John, thank you. Have a pleasant day.
Thank you, Gene, for highlighting the project of Land Bank on clean energy.